We're out here in Sagehen Experimental Forest in California, taking recordings of mountain chickadees for my work on vocal behavior and syntax of different chickadee calls. We just parked the car by the creek, which is usually where the chickadees hang out. I heard some calls, so we're gonna go and see if we can find them. It's October 21st, 2024, time is 10:20. We are a little bit past feeder 2 at high, and there's some distant chickadees, so we're gonna see if we can locate them. Hear that? That's a gargle. Mm-hmm. And that's an alarm. We're hearing a lot of little short calls, and so in the fall, they're forming their flocks for the winter, so they're figuring out a lot of different social things, like who they're gonna be in the flock with, and so that's why we hear tons of different calls right now, so it's not the most typical ones. We also hear gargle calls, which is this really melodic, loud call, and that's their territorial call. We also hear some alarm calls, which are going to be the higher pitched doo-doo-doo-doo. Chickadees have tons of different calls. They have such a huge repertoire of calls that they use to communicate to each other, and this time of year, as I said before, they're forming flocks, so they're communicating a lot of like subtle things. And so they're doing even more calls than maybe other times of the year. This is one of our feeders. It's right up here. I have a little automated recording device on top of it. I program it to record in the morning and afternoon when I'm not here every day, so I can get as many chickadee calls as possible. On this, there's a funnel that helps capture the sound. And then this is the tiny microphone. And so basically I program it and it records for me when I ask it to. So we're generally interested in cognition in our lab, and I'm interested in how call complexity, like the gargle calls we heard, they can make them very complex or very simple. And if that says anything about their performance on spatial memory tasks, or their cognitive performance.